Christmas Rat by AsDeathBeckons. Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house not a creature was stirring, except for a mouse. But could this large rodent be really called that? No, for this is the tale of the Black Christmas Rat. It rose from some dark, deep, dastardly crack, with blood on his nose and worms on his back. He shook and he shivered, and he dripped from his nose. He walked on two legs, though he had just three toes. And this rat, this vermin, this thing that was no mouse, set off on a quest to find a warm house. He wandered through the storm, looking completely lost, his eyes shut tight, his tail covered in frost. He looked here and he looked there, but he could not find a house anywhere. He was in despair, this black, foul rat that rose from the ground. That evil little crack, the cold was so fierce, the winds blew anew. If the rat were a human, he would have turned blue. The snow was so white, the sky was too black, yet the old gods of winter continued their attack. And the rat, losing hope, almost gave up, until at last he had some good luck. There was a big house, just up ahead, with lights that shone green, purple, and red. The door was wide open, the inside was dark. The rat made a run for it, joy in his heart. Once he was inside, he was delighted to see four Christmas stockings, lights, and a tree. The stockings dripped red, and the rat had just missed it, for someone had already paid this house a visit. There were cookies and milk left out for Saint Nick, but he was not here, so the rat had his pick. And he ate until his belly was full, crumbs on his nose, mouth dripping gray drool. And then the rat went upstairs, curious to see just where the folks in this house might happen to be. He limped into a room and looked at the bed, and he saw that every single thing was covered in red. There was blood on the sheets, and more blood on the floor, blood on the walls, ceiling, and door. And in the bed was something the rat had not seen for a while, though it was not breathing. It was no doubt a child. On the dresser was a clock, no particular brand, and a balled-up note to Santa in the child's hand. The rat left the room, hid it downstairs. Something bad had happened, but he did not care. He glanced up at the stockings, all dripping with red, for each one held a single human head. Yes, a stranger had come on this Christmas Eve. He took what he wanted and then took his leave. If only little Remy remembered to lock the door, then he would still be alive at this 3:45. But the rat did not mind. He did not make a peep. He was just glad to have somewhere warm to sleep. He curled up snugly in the corner near the door, hands dripped from the stocking to the floor. But enough about the family, no need for more of that. For this was the story of the Black Christmas Rat.